Hello, right. Earlier on, I tested one of Leo's homegrown pods, the Friar's Hat or Bishop's Crown, and yeah, it's kind of an hour or so later now. I left it quite a while just to let the last of the burn kind of disappear before trying another one. Yeah, we've got the normal yellow Fatalii. Now, I'm really chuffed Leo sent me one of these. Because out of all the varieties I grew this year, Fatalii was one that I planted about 20 seeds and not one germinated. So I ended up with no Fatalii plants. I got one chocolate Fatalii plant, which I reviewed the other day. I don't know which video is going to get uploaded first. But yeah, this is the normal yellow Fatalii. Obviously not the biggest of pods, but still looks really nice, and I'm pretty sure it's still going to pack a fair punch. So I'm just going to quickly slice it open because I definitely want some seeds from it, because I hope to grow it again next year. Ooh, real strong flavour coming off it. Smell and flavour. Yeah, smells. It's got like a habanero scent underneath, but maybe it's like a sweet habanero smell with a touch of citrus. It smells really nice. You have to excuse me a minute because there's not many seeds inside and I just want to make sure I get them all, because obviously I didn't have much luck this year. Over 20 planted, not one germinating. I have read on various forums that Fatalii are actually notoriously difficult to germinate, or can be. So whether it was just a bad batch of seeds, or I just didn't have any luck, or what, I don't know. All my others germinated fine. Okay. Oh, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, I've got about 10 seeds out of that. So fingers crossed, next year I should get one growing. Right, God, it's got a beautiful, beautiful smell coming off it. Yeah, smells really nice. Right, so there we go. Pod back together, take the top off, and give it a crack. Fatalii. Okay, make sure I gave that a good old chew to get all the flavour out of it. Oh, I got a bit down the back of my throat then. It didn't taste quite as sweet as it smelt. It still had a small amount of sweetness to the taste. A little bit citrusy. And yeah, you get that habanero kind of flavour coming through. Oh, the heat's coming now. Oh, just one little bit caught up on the top inside of my cheek. It's created a little pinpoint pocket burn. Felt very little heat while I was chewing it up, but it's rapidly building now. Fatalii rated, I'm not sure what the exact ratings are actually for the Fatalii. I'm pretty sure it's rated up amongst the top habanero levels and even a bit more. I know in the chili eating competition they rated it 600,000 Scoville units. I think that's a little bit generous personally, but you're talking easily up around the 400,000, maybe 500,000 mark. Producing heaps of drool. It's a real solid burn on the top of my tongue. I feel it a little bit in the throat and kind of just a little bit everywhere, but the top of the tongue is taking a right pounding from that. It's a nice tasting pod though. I prefer that to the normal habanero flavour. I thought it was going to be a touch sweeter, but no, it wasn't. It definitely smelt sweet and it tastes, but really nice flavour. A little bit citrusy. Excuse me. Not put any on any hiccups yet. Possibly because it's quite a slow builder. That's where it does differ from a habanero. It's a much more gradual build of heat. Habaneros just punch you in the face normally. I did a test the other day with an orange habanero, and for what is really regarded as one of the mildest habaneros, it really hit me hard, hiccups and everything. This is a bit more gradual, but top end heat, yeah, hot in the orange. Really making my nose run. Producing heaps of drool. I think it's a similar level of heat to the chocolate actually. I can't really remember. If anything, it might be slightly warmer than the chocolate. The chocolate was strange. The chocolate had no heat at the bottom, and then right at the top was where all the heat was. Mind you, I ate all that in one go, so I don't know, but to me the heat seemed fairly consistent throughout that pod. Heaps and heaps of drool. Tiny, my eyes are bordering on watering a bit. But it's not unbearable. It's quite a pleasant burn. It's a bit different because it's not really attacking many other places in the mouth. It's just the top of the tongue. It's just being pounded with heat. Just kind of spread my tongue around the mouth, just see if I can spread the heat around a bit and feel it kind of on the top of my palate and a little bit on the inside of my lips. Nothing in the throat, but definitely concentrated on the tongue. Might have to look at a couple of other videos. I might watch Neil's video back, the Fatalii, to see if it kind of hit him in the same place. But yeah, definitely a big tongue attacker. Awesome. Just from the few little seeds I got there on the plate, I'm getting a smell. That lovely sweet fruity habanero smell coming across. It smells beautiful. Definitely back on the grow list for next year. The Fatalii and the chocolate Fatalii for that matter. Chocolate Fatalii is awesome. I think chocolate Fatalii is possibly a little bit sweeter and fruitier than the yellow Fatalii, but that is a really nice tasting pod. Right, not much more to say really. The heat's definitely peaked. It's kind of lingering at quite a high level, but yeah, it's not getting any worse. And I think it's just going to stay for a while and linger on. And yeah, I'll put it in the comments how long it kind of stayed for. Excellent. Right. Excuse me. Leo, thanks, buddy, for sending that. Awesome job. Make sure you go and check out Leo's channel, Homegrown UK Chili. And that's chili spelt with one L. I'll put it down in the description, video description. But yeah, make sure you go and check out his channel. We've done loads of vids together in the past, done some really crazy, silly things, big heap spoons of Satan's shit and stuff like that. Stuff I really don't recommend. But yeah, go and check him out. Still reviewing with Jim. And yeah, hopefully one day we will reunite and test together. So cool, thanks for sending that, mate. Awesome. And thanks for watching. I'll catch you soon.